How's it going, guys? Today, Chad and I are excited to show you this beautiful 1964 Impala Supersport. This car, we took it in on trade a couple weeks ago. It came out of the state of Oklahoma. A very solid car, beautifully done. An air car, too.
Yeah, really nice car, guys. We took it in on trade, and it came with a full appraisal. This thing was appraised in the high 40s by a licensed appraiser, and it's a super sweet car, guys. I mean, this car is ready to hit your garage. Ice cold air conditioning. The air conditioning was completely gone through. Dalton will pop the hood here and we'll see what this thing's got for options. So as we look underneath the hood, previous owner did tell me that it was the original 327, but they decked it and planed it. So the factory numbers are no longer on there anymore. Motor's been rebuilt. So I'm not sure, guys, on the 327 if it is the original one, but it was, the owner did state that it was. Air conditioning's all been gone through. The restoration on this car, the paint and stuff, Dalton, I think was done probably 10, 15 years ago. But all in all, the car is just in excellent shape.
Yeah, it is. Power brakes, power steering, ice cold air conditioning. I mean, all great things to have.
Yeah, nice. This is a luxury car. These super sports are just made to drive, enjoy. It's got the 2-speed power glide, 327 4 barrel, stock manifolds, stock radiator. I mean, no one's customized this car whatsoever. Dalton's gonna go ahead and start this car up for us for just a second here. That's good. The motor sounds awesome. As soon as we get done with this walk around, guys, we'll take it for just a little spin here today as well. As we go underneath the hood, like I said, everything's in excellent shape. This car checked in just awesome when it came in. Very, very well taken care of car. As we go to the front grille and front bumper, the front bumper obviously has been completely re-chromed. The grille, the headlight surrounds, hood molding, all of that's in excellent shape. As far as we look at the top of the fender to the top of the hood, it lines up perfectly across. Very nice gap from front to back as well. Chrome in the middle is nice. Again, the paint job was done 10, 15 years ago, and it has an awesome shine, a super straight body from front to back. And these 64s are long. The quarter panels are super long and very hard to get straight. Mm-hmm. So this one being as straight as it is just an absolute miracle on these cars.
And this car's won a lot of awards too. When it came in, the back seat was filled with some first place awards.
Okay, so. Cool. I didn't know that. As far as the tires go, the tires are in excellent shape. They're Cooper Cobras. SS hubcaps, factory hubcaps on it as well. The windshield looks crystal clear, guys. We got nice wiper arms on there. They're all nice. The chrome's nice there. And the fit on the back side of the hood is in really nice shape. Top of the fender, top of the cowl, door, all lines up well. This is a really quality car. The only thing I noticed when it came in, and you kind of called me up on it, you said the detail guys noticed a few little blemishes on the very lower part of the car. A couple of those are right here, guys, and that's because the paint's just a little bit older. But as we go into the bottom side, it's absolutely rust-free original metal down here. You can just see the original lip. There's no body filler whatsoever. But we do have a few little bubbles right there. Rocker panel is great. Lower door is in excellent condition. And again, the pinch well, look how that was all painted and done. The bottom of the car is nice and clean. You can go to our website, coyoteclassics.com. There you'll see approximately 25 pictures of the undercarriage, showing you just how solid it is. The back corner of the door lines up really nicely. We do have a few little paint chips right here. Actually, we don't. Apologize, just a little bit of dirt right there. I did notice one thing from inside to outside. It's harder for us to see the imperfections inside, Dalton. So you'll have to kind of keep an eye out. I noticed outside they kind of show up on these cars a little easier. As far as the roof goes, the roof's perfect. No dings, dents. The chrome around here is in excellent shape. All the stainless and chrome and glass is just super clean.
I did notice there's a few chips that have been touched up maybe.
Yeah, very light maybe right there. Very, very small little bubble right there. Again, here's our inside of the quarter, which is all solid original right in here. Very nice metal. That's not behind the rear wheel is excellent. Inside this lip is all nice and solid as well. Our chrome tips come out just like they should, really nicely. The back bumper is beautiful, fits excellent here. Just superb chrome. And again, very, very straight car, guys. No disappointments in this one. Tail light trim, the back bumper, all the back SS trim is really in great shape.
I love just the looking at the backside of this car. You know, the way the lights are in 64, and those dual antennas are just cool.
Yeah. Do you want to pop the trunk? We'll show them how nice that is, bud.
This car, when we go and drive it, can we play like Boys in the Hood?
Have it jump up and down.
Cruising down the street in my 64.
Have it jumping up and down a little bit.
Yeah.
I don't think this one will be that D.
You don't think so?
I don't think so. I don't think it's a good idea. The 64 Impalas, man, they are iconic, aren't they?
Yeah, they are. They're a sweet car.
So check this trunk out. I mean, this car, guys, the whole damn car is like this. The quality of this car. So as we look in here in the quarter areas, all new rubbers. The speckling is done super professionally.
Looks like brand new spare.
Yeah, an SS hubcap, brand new spare, just like the rest of the tires. So many of these 64s, Dalton, were just rusty pieces of crap, man. This one's super solid. Really nice trunk compartment. All right. As far as the rest of it goes, we'll go in here to the interior. The exterior is just fantastic. So as we open the door is closed perfectly, lines up nice. We go ahead here and check out the paint in the door jamb. So obviously the doors, fenders, trunk, hood, everything was painted off the car. The jams are just as nice as the exterior paint on the car. Bottom corners of the doors, lower fenders, everything's in excellent shape. Door panel is fantastic. The original Super Sport door panel, armrest, bases look like they've all been replaced. As we go into the seats, they've also been all recushioned. So the cushions and the bolsters on these seats are perfect. Carpets, sill plates. The interior has definitely been completely restored and they did an awesome job. So there's a lot of cushion in the seats, very comfortable. The chrome applique on the interior is perfect. It's got an AM, FM, digital cassette radio in here. Aftermarket gauges. Other than that, you have your factory hot, cold, oil, and engine up here. So I like the added gauges here just to let us know where we're at for temp, oil, pressure. It does have the factory tachometer and it works perfectly. Factory buckets, console. Headliners all been professionally done. Visors does have the original rear view mirror, nice and tight, but there is a few pits there. But the seats, door panels, carpet, back seat, back shelf, headliner, everything is fantastic, guys. The closer I look at this 64 Super Sport, I really love it, Dalton.
Me too. We don't get too many.
It's a cool color too. The pastel yellow looks really good on this. As far as the passenger side from our driver's side from right here, it's just as nice as the passenger side. Inside here is all in great shape. As far as the top of our doors, guys, they line up perfect. The trim lines up nicely. Bottom corner of the door fits in there nice. The little drip rails are all painted nice down here. Again, just like on the other side, we do have a few little blemishes right there on that lower fender. It's something that can definitely be taken care of, but the paint is so damn nice on this car and it's so clean. I chose just to leave it just the way it is, guys. I mean, it's a great car. Just like the passenger door, as we open and close, shuts nicely with all new rubbers, stoppers on it. Door panel on the driver's side. Getting in and out, we got a little bit of dust on there, guys, but it's brand new, looks fantastic. cord and shears, your factory VIN number. And the dash, the paint on the dash, dash pad itself, everything is fantastic. So guys, check this 1964 Impala out. We'll be adding a driving video soon.
All right, so we got this 6.4 Impala on the road.
This 64 Impala is absolutely sweet. And I'm just sure by the way this thing looks and the way it sounds so far, it's gonna drive as nice as it looks, guys. Let's go through some of the stuff that works and what don't work. We talked about it, power steering, power brakes, air conditioning does work. We double checked all that. So here's your factory air. Right now it's cold out, so we'll need the heat, but the air and heat both work on the car.
Factory tach, that works too, I believe, doesn't it?
Factory tach works perfect. Right here at an idle, I mean, no foot on the gas pedal. It's idling right now on a cold start at 1,000 RPM. Perfect. Wipers are in working order as well. I'm guessing this is the factory power glide, guys. Yep, 2-speed power glide. And our idle is just a little high right now at 1,000, but we'll kick that down a little bit here. There we go. This car's super comfortable. I made a mention of it. It's got brand new seat covers, and they went ahead and did all new pads on them too.
Yeah, so they are very comfortable and very roomy too. This is a big boy car.
Yeah, it is. Look at that.
Gets up and goes.
Yeah, the kickdown works great. 327 4 barrel, 2-speed power glide, factory tach. Fantastic car. Just making sure we got the 2-speed.
Carries good oil pressure.
Yeah, we're doing 60 mile an hour right now. Yeah, carries great oil pressure, 70 pounds. Temperature's right around 150. Gas gauge works. I mean, this car just pulled. It's got some lower factory rear end gears on it. This car just freaking goes. There's 85 mile an hour right now. 90 mile an hour, it says, on the speedometer, we're doing about 4,300 RPM, so as far as going nice down the road, it's a windy day today, but if you can get this, but we've got one finger on the wheel, and that steering wheel is just like brand freaking new. So is the column and the paint on the dash.
Hey, why don't you drop it down to like 5560, see what our RPMs are.
Okay.
I don't think everybody's gonna be driving 90.
Well.
So we're at 65 right now.
We're about at 55, 57 mile an hour, and RPMs are about 2,800.
Perfect.
So I'm not sure on those gears, but I'm guessing you're probably like 373, 355, something like that. No, you only got 2-speed power glides here, so. Drives awesome, fantastic, handles great.
Yeah, it does.
Just
really
to go.
Yeah, it is. Check it out on our website, guys, coyoteclassics.com. Give us a call. It's a beautiful 64 Impala.